Hi folks, today we add one more panel to our collection, and the driver of this panel is the PT6311. We already discussed this drive a lot of times, but the important today is make one suggestion to how power up our panels with the VFD drivers. As I refer always, the most important thing about the power up of the VFD drivers is the importance of the three power sources are total independent. And you can see here in this lit draw, you have one power source, two, and three. I have one more, only to do it as example, but in the reality we need three independent power sets. The first independent power source will be responsible to power up the filaments, and because I'm using a regulator of the 5 volts DC, is necessary drop a little the voltage to don't burn the filaments, okay? In this case, I had two diodes and respect the polarity of the circuit. If you see here, you have the input, common pin, and output pin. This output pin is the plus 5 volts, go through this diode, pass the filament and return to our circuit with the second diode. Why I apply two diodes? Because the diode will force a drop of near of the 0.7 volts in each diode. Okay, these represent 1.4 volts, and if you have 5 volts, you will get a value near of the 3.6, okay? This is a good value to power up the filament. Of course, the ideal case is use the AC voltage to the filament, but okay, I don't have a second arrow of the transformer with a voltage of the AC near of the 3.6 volts. The second circuit of the power up you have here is also based on the 7805. This is a 5 volts DC, okay? And as you can see here, this power source will be responsible to power up our logic circuit, okay? In this case, you can think in this plus 5 volts as responsible to power up our driver. In this case, PT6311, but okay, can be another which use 5 volts DC. The third power source, in this case, I'm using 7824. You can see the input, common pin, and output, and this is a positive LDO regulator. This represent will give at output the 24 volts DC, okay? And now please pay attention. This is output of the plus 24 volts. And you can see I go connect direct to our GND, or in this case our 0 volts, or the common point to all circuits we have connected, okay? We already have connected the GND or 0 volts of the 5 volts DC source to the GND. These represent, if I connect the positive of this circuit to the GND, I will stay in the common pin with less 24 volts, okay? This is the reason why all the power source must be independent. I have one second option to the get negative voltage. In this case, I'm using 7924. This is a LDO also, a linear regulator of DC, but in this case is negative. 7.8 is positive, 7.9 is negative. And you can see now, in this output, I have less 24 volts, and I go direct to the second option to make the reference of our filaments. Note, this is only possible due to this kind of the connections because the 3, or in this case the 4 independent power sources. The compounds we are used to do it the 4 independent power sources, as you can see, 1, 2, 3, 4 bridge. I put tiny wire at the pins of the compounds to avoid broken the space of the breadboard. As you can see, I extended with a tiny wires to go inside of the breadboard without danifying this. I apply this solution to the bridge and the two LDOs. The capacitors is not necessary, okay? You can see 1, 2, 3, 4 output capacitors belongs to each LDO. Here you have the both diodes I use to drop the voltage to the filaments. This is a resistor to protect the Arduino, and the one important thing is the please don't forget to apply the GND of the Arduino pins. In this case, go direct to our common pin or GND pins, okay? I'm using the power up of the PC to power up the Arduino, but of course you can apply the 5 volts here in the Arduino coming from this power source. This power source here is the second option I referred before to provide the less 24 volts, okay? You can use one or other, okay? You don't need the both. In the total, you need 3 independent power sources. You can think 1, 2, 3 or 1, 2, 3. You make the option of the one or the other. Here you can see the waves of the AC voltage. Smith cycle positive, Smith cycle negative. This is AC voltage in the normal wave. This is AC voltage after pass through the bridge rectifiers. Okay, you can see here you have 4 bridge to rectify the AC voltage. Don't have any filter. Here you can see I have added the line of the filter. The filter in this case is a capacitor applied to the output of the bridge, and this allow the regulate of the linear line of DC. Of course, if our capacitor is not well calculated, we will stay in front of the ripple voltage. But to the currents we are working, this is not relevant. We stay in front of a line, a continuous line, because our current is too low, okay? I'm using the capacitor of the 330 microfarads, 63 volts, okay? This is important, the voltage is necessary be higher of the 24 volts with a margin the secure. Okay, I see at least 35 volts at least. Okay, I will like remember that the sector voltage 230 or 110 is very dangerous. Please respect all rules when working with this voltage. Proceed to the correct isolation of the pins. A common mistake is the people forgetting that they have the PC grounds plug connected to the GND of the Arduino. This results in a big problem if you try to connect the probe of one scope to see the signals, because it results as a short depending on the secondary to which you apply the oscilloscope probe. To avoid this, you must use a transformer to isolate the oscilloscope sector plug, or do the measures without applying the reference on the independent source. The another problem is working with the wires of the primer with bad isolation and don't see the dangers of the presence of the ground of the Arduino, which is the GND of the plug of the PC. This is very, very dangerous. This is our transformer. You have four secondary coils, okay? And if you look to the recommendations I have done, all the wires is correct, isolated. And I have a fuse, I have a standard plug connector, and also I have the correct voltage selected by the connections of the selector, okay? This is very important. Now the power up of the Arduino coming from the our logic 5 volts. This is the power sensor responsible to power up our PT6311 with the 5 volts DC, and at the same time now is powered up our Arduino with the plus 5 volts. Also, I like to refer, I have added the presence of the capacitors of each LDO, the output of each LDO. I already referred this, but is not present in the schema. And you can see the plus of the capacitor to the output of the 5 volts DC, plus output of 5 volts DC, plus 24 volts, output of positive regulator. And now pay attention to the last regulator. You're working with negative voltage. This means here you have less 24 volts. By this reason, this is negative of the capacitor, and the positive of the capacitor is the common pin. This is a selector take place here in these wires, or I connect to the positive regulator or to the negative regulator. But you put less 24 volts here or less 24 volts here. You only need one of the power sets. This is the secondary of the transformer. You can see I have one secondary of 7.5 volts, a second coil with a 7.5, one 2 times 7.5, which result in the 15 volts because I don't use the middle point. And also I have a coil with 18 volts at secondary. The intensity of the current is not relevant. Anything over 300 milliamperes enough to the currents we are using, okay? One last observation, because of course In this circuit here, we power up with 15 volts AC. If you multiply 15 by square root of the 2, this represents near of the 21 volts or 22 volts AC. This is not enough to fill full the requisites of the regulator here present. But this is not represent any problem, because the important is the regulator will work if the input is greater of the less 24 volts. Any other situation will pass the value present in the input. This is our current to the filament. This is our current to the negative voltage, and as you can see, the variation between the full fill of the display or less segments bright. But anyway, is a low current. This is the last current of the 5 volts logic. This is responsible to power up our PT6311, our LEDs, and also the Arduino. About our panel, you can see you have the 5 keys. Also, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9 digits. You can see here this bright of the segments. It not belongs to the digit number, because I send also digit 9, and digit 9 is not able to be represented to these fixed letters, okay? And you have a symbol of the antenna, of the tower. The PT6311 already told is the driver used in this panel. You have infrared receiver. Also, you have the 4 outputs to control external device. In this method, I use or apply it this output to control these LEDs here. Okay, RGB LED and a standalone LED of the blue. And when I start the process, the colors of the LEDs is controlled by these 4 outputs, as you can see. And that's all.